There have never been more opportunities for success than there are today. The options are endless, and unless you carefully prioritize your tasks, it's easy to become overwhelmed and procrastinate. Think about this. If you were to begin each day by eating a frog, you could go through the rest of the day with the relief that the worst part is behind you. Your biggest task of each new day is your frog. This task will most likely have considerable consequences and a lasting impact on your future. This is also the one you are most likely to procrastinate on, unless you are intentional about your actions. Eat that frog first. When you learn to overcome the habit of procrastination by eating that frog, you open yourself to a whole new world of opportunity and success. Set the table. Clear goals are directly related to productivity. People often procrastinate because they have vague goals. They aren't sure what they should be doing, how they should go about it, or why it's important. Clarity, on the other hand, is motivating. Writing your goals is especially powerful because it makes your plans tangible. Consider these 7 steps for understanding and accomplishing your goals. 1. Decide exactly what you want or need to accomplish. If it's a task that's been delegated to you, discuss with your superior what's required and which aspects take priority. 2. Write your goal or goals down. This is the fastest way to gain clarity and remove any doubts about what you need to do. 3. Set a deadline. Without an end in mind, there will be no urgency in your work, and it will be extremely easy to procrastinate. 4. Make a list of every step required to accomplish your goal. You will have a better understanding of what the entire process entails when you see each portion laid out. 5. Formulate a plan based on the list. Prioritize the tasks and understand how they relate to one another. 6. Take action immediately. Even if your first drafts are rough, it's better to start and edit than to never start at all. 7. Commit to doing at least one thing each day. Each accomplishment, no matter how small, should move you toward your final goal. If necessary, add it to your daily calendar. These steps give you a clear understanding of what you're doing and why. The more you see yourself accomplishing, the more motivated you will be to keep moving toward the final goal. Plan every day in advance. If you want to eat your biggest frog, it's essential to plan ahead. Breaking down your goals into step-by-step tasks makes it easier to get started. Though it's an initial investment of time, it will save you time down the line. Just think, stopping for directions may take 10 minutes, but plowing ahead without a map could cost you hours in the long run. Just 10 minutes of planning before your workday is shown to save you up to 2 hours of time that would otherwise be wasted. Also, it's extremely helpful to make a list the night before, because it gives your subconscious a chance to mull things over. Multiple lists that connect overarching goals to more granular tasks are even better. Start with one main list that encompasses everything you want to do. There is no time constrictions on this list, just get it all down on paper. Next, move to your monthly list. Write down everything you need to achieve in the next month. After this, you can plan for the coming week with an even smaller list. Finally, prepare a list for each individual day. All of these lists will work together to give you a sense of cohesion, while also making your tasks attainable. Apply the 80-20 rule to everything. The rule of 80-20 says that things are typically divided into 2 categories: the vital few, the top 20%, and the trivial many, the remaining 80%. This rule can be applied to many scenarios, but in regards to time and task management, understand that your most valuable tasks, your frogs, will generally only comprise about 20% of your to-do list. Even though these tasks are harder to start and might be more intimidating, they statistically take the same amount of time as less important ones. What's more, the trivial many tasks tend to multiply, meaning you will always be working but never really getting anything done. Commit to starting every day with the vital tasks, and you will see your productivity and your sense of accomplishment soar. consider the consequences. If all tasks are either the vital few or the trivial many, how do you decide which category to place each item on our to-do list? Consequences are the key indicator of the importance of a task. Ask yourself, what will happen if I don't get this done? If completing the task has significant positive or negative consequences in the future, it's a big frog. The difference between successful and unsuccessful people is the ability to see long term. Constantly ask yourself three key questions. 1. What are my most important tasks? 2. What can only I do, and if done well, will make a big difference? 3. What is the best use of my time at this very moment? Honest answers to these questions will reveal which tasks are important and which can wait or be delegated. Use the ABCDE method continually. Plan your day and clarify your priorities and posteriorities with the ABCDE method. This is a tool so versatile that anyone from a CEO to a file clerk can utilize it and see immediate results. The first step is to make your to-do list for the day. Write down all of the tasks that are on your plate. Next, begin assigning the letters A, B, C, D, or E to each item before you start on the tasks. A, the task that you must do. This item has big consequences and cannot wait. If you have several A tasks, divide these further still into A1, A2, and so on. A1 is the biggest frog. Example, creating a presentation for your upcoming client meeting. B, the task that you should do. It has consequences, but they are mild and not nearly as motivating as the consequences for task A. Example, answering phone calls, texts, or emails. C, the tasks that would be all right to do, but don't carry do-or-die consequences. Example, having lunch with your coworker. D, the tasks that you should delegate to others. If a task can be carried out by someone else, pass it along so you can focus on more valuable accomplishments. Example, busy work, like filing or shredding documents. E, these tasks could be removed from your list. Their completion or elimination has no impact on your life or work. These kinds of tasks are often done out of habit or personal enjoyment. Example, printing documents that are now stored on a company server. The key is to never move to the next letter until you have completed the previous one. Following this rule will strengthen your willpower and increase your self-respect. And, of course, make sure you get the most important tasks done. Focus on key result areas. No matter what you do for a living, you've been hired to obtain certain results. If you're a janitor, one of your results should be a clean floor. If you're a cook, one of your results should be delicious food that brings customers back. Most roles can be broken down into roughly 5 key result areas. Clarify the key result areas in your specific role, because otherwise, you won't be able to adequately perform and accomplish goals. Once you are clear on these areas, do a self-evaluation. Grade yourself in each key area so you can clearly see where you excel and where you should improve. You probably already know your weak areas before you assign the grade, and you may find yourself avoiding those tasks. After all, no one likes to dwell on their own weaknesses. But remember, you're only as good as your weakest area.